So key messages, fundamental shift in the way we communicate. It's a world of mouth. That's very important for everyone to understand. At least I'm experiencing it firsthand, and that'll come when we talk about fashion and you. Products and services are finding consumers through social media, exactly like how Elmo found my son. And consumers are reaching peer and expert feedback on the go. And that's making the social web really influence shopping. And we don't have a choice whether to do it or not, but only how well we can do it. So this picture, it looks a lot like Facebook, right? A mall looks a lot like Facebook. Shopping, it's inherently social. There's nothing new about social shopping. Shopping has always been social. It's a process of discovery, research, purchase, and follow-up. And discovery is a big and fun part of it, and it's very social. We spend hours looking at pictures in catalogs or, you know, on television for television networks that are producing shopping images. Research is very social. Almost everyone would like to know where their friend bought that dress or what gadget is the friend using and how is it working for them. Follow-up can be very social too. You would leave behind feedback for someone else to know about a good or a bad experience you've had. And similarly, you'd go and look for those follow-ups from other consumers who've experienced products. On an average, a consumer does mention, research shows that, does mention specific brands over 90 times in conversations in a week with friends and family. So what is social commerce? You know, there are various versions floating around. It is not just Facebook commerce. It's not get your shop out there. That you need to start selling on Facebook or on Twitter. I think it's everything that, it's the coming together of social media, content, and collaborative tools which end up influencing shopping or transaction decisions. So it's a sum total of ways in which the social web is impacting commerce and hence companies. Group buying, social shopping, flash sales. These are companies which have been built inherently around the social fabric of the net. They are social companies. But then there are many companies, and we'll see some examples, which are leveraging the ability that the social web today provides to either connect where their consumers are buying or let them buy where they are connecting. And it's a great companies which are learning to leverage the power of the social web are companies which at least I believe are going to be the ones that will be surviving the next decade. So brands really can't, we don't have a choice. 3 out of 4 consumers, according to Gartner, rely on social networks for their purchase decisions. And if some research is to be followed, Forrester says that $30 billion economy would get created by 2015. Some people are predicting that Facebook commerce may be bigger than Amazon. I'm not saying all of that is going to come true, but definitely, if you just don't look at only the transaction part and look at the whole cycle of communication between the brand and between consumers that happens, which ends up influencing commerce decisions, this is here to stay, and it is going to radically change if it hasn't already changed your business or your industry for that matter. So brands do need to listen, engage, and then think about selling and servicing through this medium. Some examples before we go into the last section, which would be about fashion and you, where I'd go a little slower and then hopefully we'll open it up to questions after that. But some examples of brands, different examples that are playing this domain, at least what they're learning this domain well and getting some things right. Starbucks, I mean, we all know it's one of the, they have the largest, I think it's the number one or the number two fan page following 20 million fans or something. But, you know, we had a very interesting session in the afternoon with David Fisher, and we were talking about how this is like, who's got more fans kind of a might going out there. And it's not about that. I think it's very interesting to see some examples of what these companies are doing using the social web. A player like Starbucks has several initiatives, and I've taken 4. They're the 4 blocks out there. They have something called as My Starbucks Idea. Now here they're leveraging social web to power product innovation inside the company. They're letting consumers create ideas, they're letting consumers vote for those ideas, and they also have an action tab where they come in and say, What has Starbucks already implemented? So right from health food ideas that people are asking them to bring into the breakfast options, to even things like having bolder conversations at the Starbucks outlets, this has become a fundamental way in which the company is building its products and services for the future, and even in the short term, they're implementing it on the go. They have something called a Starbucks Digital Network. Now, typically at a Starbucks, if you guys, I'm sure most of you have been to a Starbucks outlet, you have a free Wi-Fi and you end up seeing a lot of people typing away or clicking away. They've done a very interesting innovation with Yahoo, where they're building a digital network with them, wherein what they're really saying is, take your laptop, come in, and we've got some great exclusive content for you to surf and engage with. It could be a movie trailer which is yet to hit the web, or it could be exclusive free iTunes and so on. But it's a very engaging experience that they're giving to their consumers, giving them more reasons to come back to the outlet. Their Facebook has a great initiative on where they're letting people fill Starbucks cards for their friends as gifts. So it's like a virtual currency going out there where you're actually ending up gifting points to your friends. And then they have these local feeds of Twitter, because again, Starbucks is everywhere. So they have these local feeds of Twitter where it keeps you more connected with your community on the go as to what's happening, what's interesting buzz around the space that you exist. So again, giving a very strong voice to the customer and a stake in the innovation and engaging with them. And then finally, social CRM. Threadless, a very interesting company. This company it's a community in itself. It's a t-shirt retailer, which has basically a community of people who design t-shirts and then people who buy them. It's one single community fueling design and production and buying experience. They have about 600,000 regular site visitors, and you know, if you're a site visitor, you can either become a contestant and design a t-shirt, so they have a lot of artisans and a lot of designers on that community, or you have a choice to actually go in there and vote one of the designs, or you can go and every fortnight, Threadless ends up taking the best designs, puts them into production lines, and actually retails those t-shirts back to the community. And this business is already a $17 million business and is probably one of the most viral and social business in the US, if one were to look at it in a very pure way as to how it's never, forget advertising, it doesn't even have an existence outside of that community. So it's a very interesting example. The Big Daddy, you know, articles on the web which say this is the it couple, Amazon weds Facebook, and it's very interesting because the Big Daddy actually starts to say they've been always very good at recommendations, right? Fundamentally superior, but they too have felt the need to bring the social graph in and to do things like, for example, if you were to log in with your Facebook ID on Amazon, you would get a reminder about which friends' birthdays are coming and what gifts could you give them basis the that friend's social graph as well, some inputs there, but they recommend gifts, they remind you about the birthdays, they tell you which books have been bought by your friends and what music have they surfed. So that's taking recommendations to absolutely another level. Another example that comes to my mind, which is not on the slide, is TripAdvisor. In the travel industry, nobody's got recommendations and reviews as well as TripAdvisor does. They're on Facebook and they're taking that to the next level. So obviously these companies are seeing some great value in doing this. This is an example, before I get the video on, small video about Macy's, hardcore traditional retailer. While they've taken some part of their shopping online, I think this example says if you're an offline retailer or an offline brand, it's a great example of how they've taken the consumers when they're buying at their offline store to actually start sharing content with their friends. Now, typically when you wear a dress, it's typical example, five girls go shopping together or a family goes shopping together. You come out of the trial room and you're going to ask the other person, how am I looking? This is what Macy's is doing, using the social web, letting you connect with your friends after you try an outfit and ask them whether this is fine, should I buy it? Can I have the video, please?
Technology has changed the way we shop, online, on our phones, on the go. But the retail experience, that's hardly changed at all. No one knows that better than Macy's. The iconic department store wanted a way to connect with their digital savvy customers on the biggest shopping night of the year. Our idea?
Welcome to Macy's Magic Fitting Room, a whole new way to try on clothes.
A magical mirror that bridges the gap between the fitting room experience and the social web. Shoppers get to try on clothes via a full-length interactive mirror. Like what you see? When you're done, share your new outfit on your wall seamlessly. You can even get a text that tells you where to find it in the store. So how do we do it? We audition dozens of candidates to find the perfect hosts. Capture thousands of the season's hottest looks. And with the help of a talented crew and a top stylist, we put all the pieces together to create the Macy's Magic Fitting Room. We kicked off Fashion Week fittingly, in style. Thousands lined up and signed in to share the experience at an event that featured some of the world's brightest stars. We opened up new possibilities for the future of retail. Call it social retailing. And with a little of our magic, we helped countless customers find their own.